SpaceX is repurposing oil rigs to build a Starship spaceport that will be in operation in 2022. The aerospace company purchased two oil rigs, named them Phobos and Deimos, like the moons of Mars. In this video, we are going to look at SpaceX is repurposing oil rigs to build a Starship spaceport that will be in operation next year. We are also going to look at SpaceX has almost completed a test tank, meant to ensure that Starship's Super Heavy booster is capable of withstanding the immense thrust. The oil rigs are currently located in South Texas at the Port of Brownsville, which is close to SpaceX's Starbase facility where Starship is under development. The spacecraft will require a gigantic Super Heavy rocket booster to propel it to orbit, because the launch system will be very noisy. Launching from a spaceport at sea far from cities will be the best option to conduct frequent trips. Ocean spaceport Deimos is under construction for launch next year, SpaceX founder Elon Musk announced, May 30. Besides landing astronauts on the moon and transporting hundreds to colonize Mars, Musk also envisions a future where Starship can function for Earth-to-Earth transportation, like airplanes. Most Starship spaceports will probably need to be approximately 20 miles, 30 kilometers offshore, for acceptable noise levels, especially for frequent daily flights, as would occur for point-to-point flights on Earth, he said. Refurbishing oil rigs will come with an expensive price tag. I hope we don't go bankrupt building them, Musk said via Twitter in February. A South Texas pilot recently flew over the Port of Brownsville, Texas, and captured a photograph of SpaceX's Deimos spaceport that will support orbital-class Super Heavy launches. The oil rig is currently undergoing refurbishment. It features a helicopter pad with its name in yellow letters. The spaceport is expected to feature a giant launch tower that will be capable of supporting the booster as it returns from space. Engineers aim to develop a fully reusable Starship Super Heavy launch vehicle, capable of being reused at least 3 times a day. Super Heavy must be capable of being rapidly reusable. For that purpose, SpaceX will design a launch tower that could quickly catch the booster after it launches the Starship spacecraft to orbit. We're going to try to catch the Super Heavy booster with the launch tower arm, using the grid fins to take the load, Musk said. The company's Falcon 9 rocket also features grid fins, which are used to control the vehicle as it descends. Engineers will utilize the same feature for Super Heavy but modify it to support the vehicle's landing. SpaceX aims to conduct the first orbital flight test this summer, net no earlier than July 1. Teams are rapidly building prototypes of the Super Heavy booster. The company already launched 5 stainless steel Starships on high-altitude flight tests and is getting ready to launch the 6th. They have not tested a booster prototype yet because it will require a launch tower. To support a debut orbital test flight, SpaceX is building an orbital-class launch tower on land, along the Gulf of Mexico off the coast of Boca Chica Beach. SpaceX has almost completed a test tank, meant to ensure that Starship's Super Heavy booster is capable of withstanding the immense thrust of more than 24 Raptor engines. Believed to be known as Test Tank BN2.1, the prototype's latest appearance comes on the heels of news from CEO Elon Musk that SpaceX has upgraded Super Heavy with one extra Raptor engine, with plans to add another 3 down the road. The results of that tank's imminent test campaign will likely be crucial, as the company shifts its focus sending Starship to orbit, or close, as soon as possible. Prior to a new Super Heavy booster thrust puck, design first spotted on May 29, at least 2 separate booster engine section prototypes completed, in the last few months sported an earlier variant more akin to a donut. At that point, Super Heavy's design had a central cluster of 8 gimballing, throttleable Raptors surrounded by a ring of 20 Raptor boost, R-boost, engines, a variant meant to trade the ability to throttle for approximately 25% more thrust. While Super Heavy booster BN1's almost immediate scrapping, prior to a single test, guaranteed that major design changes were on the way, exactly what those changes would be was anyone's guess. The appearance of a new booster, thrust puck, design and Musk's subsequent announcement that Super Heavy will, initially, have 29 not 28 Raptors likely mean that that engine section redesign was a major contributor to BN1's instant obsolescence. The only other major change SpaceX clearly made with booster BN2 was switching the positions of its liquid methane and liquid oxygen tanks, ensuring that Super Heavy's heavier oxidizer is closer to the rocket's base. Musk also stated that SpaceX will eventually upgrade Super Heavy to 32 engines, giving future boosters a central cluster of 12 engines, that the SpaceX CEO says, will significantly improve the efficiency of boost-back burns. With 29 identical Raptors, the simplest possible Super Heavy booster would produce up to 5,800 tons 12.8 million lbf of thrust at liftoff. If SpaceX has already completed Raptor boosts design and qualification, and kicked off mass production of a 250 MTF engine, that liftoff thrust climbs to 6,800 tons, approximately 15 million lbf. If SpaceX achieves performance goals approximately 210 MTF stop, approximately 300 MTF R-boost, mentioned by Musk last year, a 32-engine Super Heavy could achieve peak liftoff thrust, greater than 8,500 metric tons, approximately 18.7 million lbf. Even in its weakest configuration, Super Heavy will still be more than 60% more powerful than Saturn V, and 25% more powerful than N1, the largest rockets to have ever successfully or unsuccessfully flown. That immense thrust demands a structure capable of surviving those extreme forces, while simultaneously feeding dozens of Raptors up to approximately 28 metric tons, approximately 61,000 pounds of propellant every second, and withstanding several thousand tons of liquid oxygen, all without leaking, cracking, or flexing too much. While BN-2.1 won't have any of the plumbing associated with dozens of Raptors, 9 hydraulic rams will let SpaceX subject its Super Heavy thrust structure to the simulated thrust of some number of engines. Given the presence of 9 rams and 9 clustered engines, it's unclear if BN-2.1 will only test that main thrust structure, or if those rams will somehow be spread out to simulate the thrust of a full 29 engines, 20 of which will instead transfer most, or all of their thrust into Super Heavy's skirt. Regardless, if successful, BN-2.1's test campaign should leave SpaceX on track to attempt Starship's inaugural spaceflight as early as Q3 2021. If issues arise, that target could easily slip to Q4 or into 2022, but SpaceX's test tank campaigns have historically been very successful. SpaceX is ready to conduct the 22nd cargo mission to the International Space Station as part of NASA's second Commercial Resupply Services, CRS-22 contract. On Thursday, May 27, the Dragon spacecraft was transported from SpaceX's processing facility at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station into a hangar, where it was attached atop a Falcon 9 rocket. Dragon is loaded with about 7,300 pounds of cargo, critical materials that will directly support dozens of the more than 250 science and research investigations that will occur during Expeditions 65 and 66, the agency said in a press release. Inside Dragon's unpressurized trunk, or three pairs of solar arrays to increase the space station's power capacity, that will be installed by the crew on an upcoming spacewalk. Some of the cargo inside the pressurized cabin includes sensitive science materials and equipment to conduct science research, supplies needed for the seven-member crew, and even tiny creatures will travel to space. The creatures are tardigrades and bobtail squids, which will aid in conducting scientific research. Tardigrades will be used to study how the creatures can survive under extreme conditions. Advancing our understanding of how tardigrades' biology adapts to rough environments, like microgravity, could enable scientists to obtain insight into what affects human biology in space, and how could animals and humans adapt. The bobtail squid is part of a research project that will examine the effects of going to space on the molecular and chemical interactions between beneficial microbes and their animal hosts. June 1, Falcon 9 and Dragon were rolled out to launch Pad 39A, ahead of the CRS-22 mission that is scheduled to lift off on Thursday, June 3, at 1:29 p.m. Eastern Daylight Saving Time. The uncrewed spacecraft will operate autonomously. It is scheduled to arrive to ISS by Saturday, June 5. Dragon will dock to the space station's Harmony module at 5 a.m. Eastern Daylight Saving Time. NASA astronauts Megan MacArthur and Shane Kimbrough prepared for the Cargo Dragon's arrival with 3D computer training. They will be monitoring Dragon early Saturday, ensuring it safely approaches the station during its automated rendezvous and docking. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.